Hello children, welcome back to your science class. So children, today we are going to discuss something about alkalis. We have seen that acids give H3O plus or H plus ion in water. In our previous class, we have already studied. Let us see what happens when a base is dissolved in water. NaOH, when it is dissolved in water, it separates into Na plus and OH minus. KOH, when dissolved in water, it gives K plus OH minus. MgOH twice in water gives Mg2 plus plus 2 OH. So, bases generate hydroxide ions in water. Bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. Do you know all bases do not dissolve in water? An alkali is a base that dissolves in water. They are soapy to touch, bitter and corrosive. Never taste or touch them as they may cause harm. Now, as we have identified that all acids generate H plus and all bases generate OH minus, we can view the neutralization reaction as follows. So now we already know that acids give H plus and bases give OH minus. Acid plus base gives salt plus water. HX plus M OH gives MX plus HOH. The process of dissolving an acid or base in water is highly exothermic one. Care must be taken while mixing concentrated nitric acid or sulfuric acid with water. The acid must always be added slowly to the water with constant stirring. If water is added to concentrated acid, the heat generated may cause the mixture to splash out and cause burns. So whenever we treat acid, we should treat it properly. The glass container may also break due to excessive local heating. Look out for the warning sign on the can of concentrated sulfuric acid and on the bottle of sodium hydroxide pellets. Mixing an acid or base with water results in decrease in the concentration of ions per unit volume. Such a process is called dilution, and the acid or base is said to be diluted. Why do HCl, HNO3 show acidic characters in aqueous solution, while solutions of compounds like alcohol and glucose do not show acidic character? The dissociation of HCl or HNO3 to form hydrogen ions always occur in the presence of water. Hydrogen ions combine with H2O to form hydronium ions, that is H3O plus. Why does an aqueous solution of an acid conduct electricity? Acids dissociate in aqueous solution to form ions. These ions are responsible for the electricity. So, whatever ions are produced, they are responsible to conduct electricity. Why does dry HCl gas not change the color of the dry litmus paper? Color of the litmus paper is changed by hydrogen ions. So, dry HCl gas does not contain H plus ions. It is only in the aqueous solution that an acid dissociates to give iron. Since in this case neither HCl is in aqueous form nor the litmus paper is wet, therefore the color of the litmus paper does not change. Very, very important, children. You need to know that it is only in aqueous solution that an acid dissociates to give ions. So children, I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed, all the concepts. Thank you.